द फर्स्ट पॉलिसी अडॉप्टेड वॉज टैक्सेशन इन द दाव. सो इन ऑर्डर टू इंक्रीज द रेवेन्यू मोहम्मद बिन तुगलक इंक्रीज द लैंड रेवेन्यू इन द दाव रीजन. दाव रीजन दीज वॉज द रीजन बिटवीन द वॉटर बिटवीन द नॉट बिटवीन द वॉटर बिटवीन द रिवर्स. एंड अनफॉर्चुनेटली दिस प्लान वॉज दो इट वॉज कैरिड बट ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम वेन इट वॉज कैरिड देर वॉज अ सिवियर फैमन विच वॉज अफेक्टिंग दीज एरियाज. सो एग्रीकल्चर सफर्ड अ लॉट एंड फार्मर्स दे वर आस्क्ड टू पे टैक्सेस बाय द सुल्तान ऑफिसर्स एंड इन ऑर्डर टू सेव देम देमसेल्फ फ्रॉम द रेवेन्यूज द फार्मर्स दे वर लीविंग देयर लैंड एंड दे वर मूविंग टू सम अदर प्लेसेस. बाय द टाइम सुल्तान केम टू नो अबाउट दिस कंडीशन सो ही ऑर्डर्ड अ फाइनेंशियल हेल्प टू द फार्मर्स लाइक ही ऑर्डर्ड टू गिव देम द लोन्स then to give them the seeds or he also allowed it or dig well for irrigation. But by the time these all the things were provided to the farmers, it was too late. The population was affected more. The next reform which he started, he was a transfer of capital. So he took another step to shift his capital from Delhi to Devagiri. The capital was shifted due to many reasons. The empire has extended to the south and hence Delhi was no longer centrally located. Earlier Delhi was centrally located, so therefore they used to live in Delhi. But now though a lot of advancement was done, now Delhi was no more the center point. Devagiri was the center point at that time. So it was easy for the ruler to rule from the Devagiri. Being far away from the northwest, it was safe from the threat of the Mughal attacks also. But it was a long journey, around 708 miles from Delhi. And Muhammad bin Tughlaq soon realized that his absence from Delhi would make his capital more easable approach to the Mughals. He could not control the north from Devagiri. So he again ordered in order to return back to Delhi. Thousands of people died during the return journey. Again it was a failure. Then introduction of the token currency. The economic burden of the transfer of capital was heavy as it made the treasury empty. So what they did that in order to meet this money problem, Muhammad bin Tughlaq issued copper coins, considered equal in the value to gold and silver coins. But the Sultan did not take any step to prevent forgery. Forgery, it's to copy a legal document or object illegally. You can see the definition. On the other hand, mints were not a state monopoly and large scale imitation of royal coins began. People, they started making by their own. A large number of such coins were in circulation and trade and industry suffered because people could not differentiate between the real and fake coins. So again the Sultan withdrew the scheme and paid gold and silver coin in exchange of copper coins. Another failure. Then failures of expeditions. He wanted to expand his empire, so in order to keep more and more army, so he started giving them salary in advance. So he sent his army to conquer Central Asia, parts of the Central Asia. So for this he equipped the army with the new weapons and the soldiers were paid 1 year's salary in advance. But the repeated failures of all Muhammad plan resulted in his unpopularity. So these were some of the reforms or some of the decisions taken by him which failed.